Hi friends, today let us answer a question. What do you mean by an FIR and an IIR system? So let us see, what do you mean by an IIR system and an FIR system? An IIR system is acronym of Impulse. This is the second I. Here also you see second I. There also we have Impulse. Here we have I. That I stands for Infinite. So this I stands for Infinite. So immediately comes to mind that F will be Finite. So we have second I stands for Impulse, first I stands for Infinite, and your F stands for Finite, and R stands for Response. In both the situations, R stands for. So previously we were having a knowledge of impulse response. An impulse response of a system is the output of a system when the input is an impulse. Now I am saying that the impulse response would be finite in value, then it becomes a finite or FIR. Could be an infinite in number, that time it will be an infinite impulse response. Let us take for example. Example of infinite impulse response is h of n equals to 1 by 2 raised to n minus 0.1 raised to n the whole multiplied by u of n. Now here we know that u of n is an infinite length sequence. Okay, so this impulse response will follow or will carry till infinity. So this is an infinite length sequence. For a finite length sequence, for an example, h of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a finite length sequence where we have 4 samples in the impulse response. Such impulse responses are called as finite length. Such impulses are called as infinite length. Infinite length impulse responses are called as IIR, and finite length impulse response are called as FIR. The system which have such kind of impulse response will be called as IIR system, whereas a system with such impulse responses will be called as an FIR systems. Now, how to identify whether a given system is an FIR or an IIR system from a system equation or the difference equation? So let us take a difference equation. Y of n equals to x of n minus 0.5 x of n minus 1 plus 0.2 x of n minus 2 minus 0.1 x of n minus 3. This is a difference equation. Now let us identify the terms in the difference equation. This is my output, which we called as present output. Then this is my present input. What is this? This is my past input. Then I have your again past input, and lastly this term is also past input. So whenever my present output depends on inputs alone, present and past, but only inputs, that time the difference equation is an FIR system equation. So FIR system, the output depends on only present and past inputs, no outputs. Okay, so it depends output, the present output depends on the present and the past inputs alone, then that systems can be characterized or are FIR systems or finite impulse response system. So this difference equation is an example of an finite impulse response system. For an FIR, for an IIR, the opposite thing will occur. If I have y of n which is equal to x of n minus 0.5 x of n minus 1 plus say 0.2 y of n minus 1 minus 0.5 y of n minus 2 and plus 0.1 y of n minus 3. here these two input, these two values or the terms are basically the input terms. This is a present input, this is a past input. But these three terms depends or are the output terms or the past output terms. So this is a past output term, this is also a past output term, and this is also a past output term. So we have three past output terms and we have two input terms. So whenever a present output, this is my present output, depends on present, past, inputs and outputs together, then the system transfer function or then the system function is an IIR system function. So whenever I have a system function in which you see y of n minus 1, 2, 3 and so on, that is the past outputs, then the transfer function is called as a system IIR transfer function or the IIR systems. So from the given difference equation, now I can easily make out whether my system is a FIR system or an IIR system. For an IIR system, there should be past outputs. So to get back the past output for the present input, if I draw a diagram, this is my system. So if this is the input of the system, I don't draw anything over here. This is the input of the system x of n. So my FIR system, in FIR system, I will have something called as a summator or an adder. And to this, I will have all various types of input, that is x of n minus 1, x of n minus 2, x of n minus 3 and so on, and this will generate a y of n. That means my output depends only on the present and past inputs. Now to get this past inputs, I need some memory blocks to store them, but they will be inputs. They'll be coming from the user and not from the system or not from the output. They are from the user. So the whenever the output depends only on present and past inputs, that time this system is called as an FIR system. Now if I wanted to see an IIR system, then again I put a summator. This is my input x of n and this is my output y of n. In this case, I will have n number of inputs, but I will also have the outputs. Okay, so to get the past output, I have to sample or I have to get that value from the output side to the input side, because my present output depends on present and past inputs as well as past output. To get that output back, I need something called as a feedback. So in IIR system, we will have feedbacks, wherein in FIR systems, we will not have any type of feedback. So these systems are called as recursive systems. So all IIR systems are called as recursive systems, whereas FIR are called as non-recursive systems because there is no feedbacks. Now, even if I remove all the inputs, I'm going to get an input back from the output side and it will produce the output recurrently. So even though there is no input, the output will be generated because of the past outputs in the IIR systems. Whereas if I remove all the inputs in the FIR system, the output will go to zero and there is no recursion. Because of which we called IIR systems as recursive systems and FIR systems as non-recursive systems. Thank you.